Gigugma kay Kristo, mayong gabi kaninyong tanan. Thank you for joining us faithfully in our live streaming for the Holy Eucharist. In this evening, as we pray to the Lord in this Mass, we transform digital space to become sacred space. Brothers and sisters, I recall na ako'y nabasa ng article. Taas na kayo ang tsimpungan na fast. Pero ang kanyang iyang amusing insight or disturbing insight has stayed. Allow me to share this with you. Kanang kini ang perspektibo sang isa ka-American nga batan-on nga girlfriend o naka-boyfriend siya sang Italiano nga uno, known kuno kuno nga romantiko ba. At kana, sa ilahang one of those tender moments of being together, the girl sought some kind of understanding kung in terms of the depth sa ilahang relationship of love. So, kining si girl, mangutana siya sa lalaki. Ingon niya, amore, do you love me? So, medyo, sweet kaayo nga boses pa. Do you love me? Ang tubag sang lalaki, certo, si, of course, yes. Ingon sang iyang Italiano nga boyfriend. Pero dili makontento si girl. She had a follow-up question. At this time, babungay-bungay sang iyang mata. No? And then, malagkit nga eyeball to eyeball, matamis ng mga dialogue o ang iyang words. Ingon niya, where do I, no? Stand in your heart. No? And then, kung sa atong pasabisaya, asa man ko dapita sa imong kasing-kasing ba? She was actually expecting a deep reassurance, no? And a deep kind of assurance na she will be the top, no? Desire and love. Then the boy just, looked at her and maukining iyang tubag. Prima, la mama, segunda, calcio, terza, tu. Translation, first, ang nanay, ang iyang inahan. Second, football, calcio. Third, ikaw. So, ikatulo lang siya. Can you imagine how frustrated the girl must have been, no? Kanang she was expecting na number one jud siya sa kasing-kasing sang iyang boyfriend ba? And the boyfriend was very honest. Prima la mama, segunda el calcio, terza tu. Brothers and sisters, I found this very amusing, but at the same time, disturbing. Kay kining seeking for clarity, kun asa man ko in terms of ranking sa imong tagipuson or kasing-kasing, is actually a kind of a validation of their depth of love. It must have been frustrating. I can just imagine nga inaway silang duha, no? Nagpuis la pagkauman ka ng ilang dialogue. Pero I'll push the dialogue this time based on the background of the gospel challenge. And imagine this. For example, si Lord, amangutana sa imuha. The Lord will ask you, do you love me? Kita ang mga Cebuano, of course, ang atong tubag, immediate, of course, Lord, oy, no? We love you very much. Claro kaayo. And then the Lord will ask you personally, asa man ko sa imong kasing-kasing? Ah, mauna ang interesting na tubag na to. Asa man siya? Sahay, pwede kita katubag. First, ang gadgets. Second, negosyo. Ikatulo ka lang, Lord. Kana ba? O sahay, lahi-lahi ang tupag. Pero usually si Lord, third, if not last. Dili ba? Maukini ang atong human tendency. In the midst of this human tendency, maukini ang invitation sang atong Ebanghelyo karon. Here, the opening verses really challenges us in terms of re-examining the state of our relationships And please don't misunderstand the Lord. He is not telling you to love less your parents or people that you care for. No, that's not the point. The point is, in terms of relationship to persons, possessions, and situations, do we make the Lord our number one priority? Mao kini ang invitation nga very powerful na gina-proclaim karon sang ebanghelyo para sa atuhang tanan. The Lord, in terms of asking you and me, where do I stand in your heart, in your life? Who is your focus? Am I number one in your life? Why? If Jesus is the number one priority in our lives, ang implikasyon mao kini, ang atong actions, atong intentions, og affections will all be directed to Him and be guided by Him. Mao kini ang wonderful o powerful news when we make the Lord our top priority. However, the following verses really provide us why we hesitate. Nganuman, immediately after the Lord tells us in terms of really developing a relationship with Him as the number one priority in our lives, then medyo challenging kaayo kay ingon niya, pick up your cross. Unless you take up your cross and follow me, you cannot be my disciple. Mao kini si Santa Teresa, ang iyang prank ang reklamo kay Jesus, ingon niya, Lord, mauna ang gamay lang jud imong mga amigo or suod nga amigo or amiga, nganuman ang imong gift sa imong mga friends, mao ang cross. And pagkakita nato na, medyo ka about face kitang tanan kay kuyawan man ta ba sa cross. And not only that, the next verse also would unravel another thing that we want to avoid. You must lose everything. Learn to die from yourself in order to gain eternal life. Then you can follow me fully. Brothers and sisters, mao kining inakuyawan nato. We want to make the Lord our number one priority, but nakuyawan kita sa cross nga iyang gift, ug nakuyawan kita of dying to our own selves. Here's the thing. The cross, truly the Lord gives to us, but He will not give something beyond that our strength can carry. And we will be amazed that that cross is carried by the Lord side by side when we struggle. Here's the thing. When we die to ourselves, to our selfishness, to our sin, to our own greed, then we truly live, actually. Then we unlock the secrets of truly a meaningful, fruitful, and happy life. So, amazingly, if we make the Lord not the third option or the last, and make Him the number one priority in our lives, even despite the challenges and difficulties, we will truly find peace and happiness. You know, I was just talking to a relative of mine working outside, and iyaging share na kining COVID when natakdan siya ba. For the first time, she said, after so many years, she reconnected to God as her real and essential priority. She said, I lived my life relying on what I can do, what I can buy, security from money and possessions. And to a certain degree, they are fine. Ang problema lang, ingon niya, si Lord was pushed to the background already and in fact forgotten. She told me, katong iyang nasinati and what she suffered through, she was able to recover her faith and to reconnect to God as her number one priority. And because of that now, each relationship is more beautiful sa iyang family. Each possession is considered a big blessing. Each situation is a celebratory moment for the life, the second life given to her. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, kining atong ebanghelyo, kaanindot kaayo. We began with an amusing dialogue between the girl and the Italian boyfriend. Kag we realize, akin ang intubag sa lalaki, usahay, dili lang usahay, most often maunang atong tendency. the Lord becomes the third or the last option. May this gospel today stir aflame our love for Him, and may we dare say yes to make Him our priority. And even though there's the cross and there's a process of dying within ourselves, we know that when we choose Christ, this is actually the way towards fullness of life. So imagine this when you pray later, ikaw lang, o si Lord. And the Lord will ask you, anak, do you love me? And then of course, tanan kita, I'm sure you will say yes. And then He will ask, where do I stand in your heart? May we be honest to say that sometimes, Lord, dili klaro kay ikaw gitang first, but now I would like to declare you to be my top priority. That all my intentions, affections, and actions will be guided by your love and will be directed to love of you. When we do this, healing, peace, and fullness will be discovered in our lives. So help us, God.